Now in this lecture, we're going to take another look at blending modes. I'm sure most of you have images like this. In this case, it's a picture of the Abbey on top of Mont Saint-Michel in Normandy. The sky's blown out to white, and you probably think, it'd be great if I could drop another sky into there. But the idea of all that layering and masking doesn't sound very appealing. There's a blending mode that can actually do most of the work for you. Now, as we discussed in class, blending modes are basically a set of rules that define how a layer will interact with the layers below it. So if you have an image of another sky, here's an image I've got here that I took out in Whistler. I'm going to open that image up. And in the darken blending mode, the rule is the pixels will be visible only if they're capable of darkening the pixels below. And in the case of this sky here, most of these pixels can darken white. Pretty much anything can darken white. So I'm going to take this sky layer and I'm going to drag it on top of my castle image there. So I grab the sky, drag it over, and I let go. Now, obviously we have a bit more work to do. Take a look in your blending modes. Right now it's set to normal. That's the default blending mode. If I select darken, watch what happens. Now, a lot of this castle has started bringing itself through, showing up through the clouds. The reason for that, where it's white, pretty much anything can darken, so the clouds remain visible. But where the castle is darker than the clouds, the darken blending mode doesn't allow the clouds to show through. Now, we can move those clouds around. You can see I have a problem with the mountain range showing up at the bottom there. But we still have some problems. The clouds are showing up through different areas in the castle. Now, one of the things we can do to solve that is lighten up the sky. And if we take a look at the original image, you can see that this castle is obviously lit by a very bright sky. This sky that we've added in is too dark. So I'm going to use an adjustment layer to lighten the sky. So I'm going to go down to my layers panel, grab a new levels adjustment layer, and just brighten this up. Curves would work as well, but in this case I want to keep it simple, so we'll use levels. Now, as I brighten it, unfortunately the entire castle is brightening as well. We're getting the clouds lightening up, but the castle's going with it. So we need to figure out how we can stop that from happening. Let's take a look in our layers panel. We've got our adjustment layer. There's the sky layer right below it. And below that is the castle. Adjustment layers affect all of the layers below them, unless they're clipped to the layer below. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clip this adjustment layer to the sky layer. From the pop-up here, I'm going to choose Create Clipping Mask. There's about seven other ways of creating clipping masks, but that's the simplest, or holding the Option key and clicking on this little line in between the two layers there. Or I guess even clicking that little icon over there would do it too. Anyway, there's a bunch of ways of making layer masks. So we've got this clipped down below. Sorry, making clipping masks. We've got this clipped to the layer down below, and as I lighten and darken it, you'll notice the clouds impose themselves through as they get darker than the castle, but as I lighten them, they start to disappear from inside the castle because they're being lightened by this adjustment layer only on the cloud layer. So the castle stays its original density, the clouds get lightened and are then less able to impose themselves through the walls. Now the next thing I'm going to do, if we zoom in here, we can see some problems happening. Look in the lighter areas of the castle, up around the white windows, in the lighter bits of the stone. If I turn the layer off and on, this is the sky being turned off and on, we can see it imposing itself through these areas. Now what can we do to get rid of that? Well, here's the sky layer. When I turn it off, it doesn't show through. When I turn it on, it does. We can hide those areas with a layer mask. So I'm going to add a layer mask to my sky layer there, grab a paintbrush, and as I paint with black, you can see that I can hide the sky. So wherever I see the sky showing through, I can just go through, paint with black, and get rid of it. Now, be very careful when you're doing this that you don't end up getting too close to the edge. If you're using a soft brush, it's very easy to get this kind of glowing effect. You can see there as I turn this layer off and on, you get this glow around the outside. You don't want that. If you get close to the edge, try using a harder brush. Then I can go in, paint out the sky in the areas that I don't want it, anywhere it's showing up throughout the castle. There's the layer mask, and you see I'm just painting black to hide. I can see it through here. We've got a serious problem down here with that mountain range showing up, so I'll just paint that out. And some more problems on top. If I move this sky down, you can see that if this top part, this statue, goes over top of a dark part of the sky, it gets very hard to see what's going on through there. A simple way is to simply move the clouds up and put a lighter area behind it. Let's give that a try. Let's see if I can move these clouds around. We have a problem happening. As I move the clouds, the areas of the sky that I hid with the layer mask are also moving. Now, how can we stop that from happening? Take a look in the layers panel. As I drag this around, you can see that the layer mask and the layer are moving together. Look at this chain icon here. If I break that link between the two, it lets me select the sky and move it without the layer mask also moving. So now I can put a lighter area behind the castle, that little statue up there, and it still looks a little bit unusual. You can see we're kind of getting parts of it invisible. A good way to bring back the statue here and get a clean cut around it is to paint out more than you think you need. So I'm going to take my black paint and paint out more than I need, and then bring it back with white paint. So I'm kind of going around the edges there. We still get the reflection of the sky off of it, but we don't see that sky showing up in the different areas around it and through it. Now, it's a little bit unusual that this would be reflecting white when the sky around it is clearly gray. So what I'll probably do is drop the opacity on my brush a little bit and bring back some of these areas here. Just to get a little bit of that density back into it. A little bit further down, you can see that this looks like it should be a bit brighter. So I'll simply paint this in here. Again, I'm at a fairly low opacity, so I can do multiple passes to bring it back to what I want it to be. Maybe around in there as well. So that's a pretty good way of dropping a sky in without having to deal with any masking. Well, very little, just around there. But you can see that it fills in around behind the tree, around the outside, and just keep looking around to make sure you're not getting any problem areas like this. If you see any, grab that paintbrush, load it up with black paint, and just paint over top to take that off of it. Maybe a little bit more over here. Let's paint that out. Now, that's the darken blending mode. Another blending mode can help us get rid of this blue fringing around here, this chromatic aberration. Let's take a look at how we can do that. In the color blending mode, the rule is that the pixels can only impart their color onto the pixels below. So right now, where we have this blue fringe, we want it to be the same color as that stone. If I make a transparent layer, convert it to color blending mode, and paint the color that I want the pixels behind to be on top of it, that color will change to what I want it to be. So I'm going to take a look over in my layers panel here. And when I make the transparent layer, I want to put it at the top of the stack. If I make a new transparent layer now, you can see it's going to appear directly above layer 1, which would be in between levels 1 and layer 1. And since this is clipped, it would be clipped to the sky layer. We don't want that. So I'm going to select the top layer, make a new transparent layer, and I'm going to convert that from normal to color blending mode. Now I'm going to take my paintbrush, and when I hold the Option key, or the Alt key in Windows, I get that eyedropper, and I can sample the color I want this to be. In this case, I want it to be that stone gray. And as I paint over top, you can see that it imparts that stone gray color to that chromatic aberration. Now, I do want to be careful that I don't accidentally bleed out into the sky and start putting some weird colors in the sky. We don't want that to happen. But as long as I stay over top of the stone areas, you can tone out that chromatic aberration. Same thing for the green around here. I can sample the green, paint it over top, and tone that out. Now, obviously in this image, there's a whole lot of chromatic aberration around here. We don't need to take every last little bit of it out. People are used to seeing little bits of chromatic aberration in an image, so a few little flecks here and there isn't going to be too bad, but the worst of it, we can go in and just kind of take that down. Now, basically what I'm doing is I'm painting with a solid paint color, and if I convert this back to normal, you can see exactly what's happening. I'm taking paint, putting it over top of the chromatic aberration in the color I want it to be, and when I convert it to color, it imparts its color. It can't do anything else, just change the color. So those are two good ways of using blending modes to fairly quickly do what you need to get done. In the case of the sky, we dropped in a new sky, saved a whole lot of masking, saved a whole lot of time. And in the case of the chromatic aberration, we were able to paint out that blue fringe. So that's the power of blending modes.